Hello everyone, in this video we have one triangle, and these two parts are given as equal. Here is 30 degrees, here is 15 degrees, and angle alpha is asked. Okay. First step, if we extend corner A, notice that sum of the opposite interior angles equals one exterior angles, so here must be equal 45 degrees. And let's draw one perpendicular line like this, 45 degrees left here. After that, if you focus on the biggest triangle, notice that if there's a two units opposite side of the 90 degrees, opposite side of the 30 degrees must be equal one unit, right? Since this triangle is an isosceles triangle, so this side is equal to the others. Notice that here is 60 degrees, and if we connect these two points, we get an equilateral triangle. So this side must be equal to the others. And here is 60 degrees, here is also 60 degrees, and 30 degrees left here. Now, if you focus on this triangle, notice that this triangle is an isosceles triangle. It means alpha plus 45 degrees must be equal 70 degrees. So alpha is going to be 30 degrees. So that was the first method. Now we will calculate the value of alpha using second method. This time, let's extend corner A like this. Sum of the opposite interior angles equal 45 degrees, right? So let's draw one perpendicular line. Let's call here point K. So here is 45 degrees, right? Therefore, we get an isosceles right triangle. So if there's a two units here, this length must be equal to units, right? Then if we draw one more perpendicular line, notice that this blue line is middle base, right? Therefore, if here is two units, this length must be equal one unit, right? Okay. Then, if we connect these two points, notice that the base will be divided into two equal parts, and here is 90 degrees. That means this part must be equal to the others. If you focus on this triangle, this triangle is an isosceles triangle, so here is 75 degrees and 15 degrees left here. After that, if you focus on this triangle is 15, 75, 90 special right triangle. So let's remind you, let's draw here. Here is 90 degrees, here is 15, here is 75. Therefore, there's a one unit opposite side of the 15 degrees. Opposite side of the 75 degrees must be equal root 3 plus 2 units, right? So if we apply this property for the question, notice that if there's a 1 unit opposite side of the 15 degrees, opposite side of the 75 degrees must be equal root 3 plus 2 units, right? So, root 3 left here. Then, if you focus on this triangle, notice that ratio of the sides equals root 3. That means angle alpha equal 30 degrees. Or you can think like this. Tangent alpha equal 1 over root 3. That means alpha is going to be 30 degrees. Now, let's calculate the value of alpha using third methods. We know that in a triangle, sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees, so 135 degrees left here. Since 135 degrees is greater than 90 degrees, that means angle BAC is an obtuse angle. So, if we draw circumcircle of this triangle, center of the circle will be outside of the triangle. a straw circumcircle of the triangle like this. And let's call here center point. If we connect center with corners of the triangle like this, these blue lines are rays, right? Okay. If here is 15 degrees, center angle must be equal 30 degrees. Likewise, if here is 30 degrees, center angle must be equal 60 degrees. If you focus on this triangle has become an equilateral triangle, right? So triangle OAC is an equilateral triangle. Therefore, this length must be equal R units. After that, if we connect these two points, if you focus on this triangle is an isosceles triangle, so here must be equal 90 degrees. Therefore, these two angles must be equal to each other, right? Because of isosceles triangle. So here must be equal 45 degrees. And 45 degrees left here. Then here is 15 degrees, right? Notice that this triangle is an equilateral triangle and these two angles are equal. Likewise, these are also equal. It means this line is symmetry line, right? Therefore, here is also alpha. So 2 alpha equal 60 degrees. That means alpha is going to be 30 degrees. Okay. Now let's calculate value of alpha using fourth method. First step, let's draw a perpendicular line like this. Once that, if there's a y unit opposite side of the 30 degrees, opposite side of the 60 degrees must be equal root 3. Right? And let's call here A, if this side length is root 3 plus A, this side length must be equal root 3 plus A. Therefore, if you focus on this triangle, if there is a one unit opposite side of the 15 degrees, opposite side of the 75 degrees must be equal root 3 plus 2 units, right? Therefore, a plus root 3 equal root 3 plus 2. These are again 2a equal 2. That means a is going to be 1 units. It is 1. So we get an isosceles right triangle. Here is 45 degrees, right? That means alpha is going to be 30 degrees. Now let's calculate value of alpha using fifth methods. Okay. Before the solution, I'd like to mention a feature. We know that in a triangle, the angle bisectors intersects at a single point, right? If we use this property for the question, so if you take 30 degrees from here, and 15 degrees from here, if we extend this corner, they will intersect above, right? Let's call here point T, and if we connect these two points, notice that here is 60 degrees, here is 30 degrees, so 90 degrees left here. Since red line is an angle bisector line, so these are must be equal 45 degrees. If you focus on this triangle is 30, 60, 90 spatial right triangle. So there's a two units opposite side of the 90 degrees. opposite side of the 30 degrees must be equal 1 unit, right? So if these are 1 unit, here is also 1 unit, and opposite side of the 60 degrees must be equal root 3. Next step, if we connect these two points, if you focus on this triangle, triangle has become an equilateral triangle, right? So triangle BTD is an equilateral triangle. That means the line BA is symmetric line, right? Therefore, if here is 45 degrees, here is also 45 degrees. That means alpha is going to be 30 degrees. Okay. Now, let's calculate value of alpha using six methods. Let's call these equal sides x, and here let's call y. And we know that sum of the opposite two integer angles equals one exterior angles. So here must be equal 15 plus alpha. Then for this triangle, if we apply sine rule, x over sine alpha equal y over sine 15 degrees, right? Likewise, for this triangle, if we apply sine rule, notice that here is 135 minus alpha, right? Therefore, y over sine 30 equal x over sine 135 minus alpha. We know that sine 135 minus alpha equal sine 45 plus alpha, right? Then, if you multiply these two equations together, therefore, x times y over sine alpha times sine 30 equal y times x over sine 15 times sine 45 plus alpha. Therefore, if you simplify the expression, these are again. And if we move this term here, sine 45 plus alpha, likewise, let's move sine 30 here. It can be written as 1/2 instead of sine 30, right? And let's multiply with cosine 15, numerator and denominator. Here must be equal sine 30, right? And we can calculate sine 75 degrees instead of cosine 15 degrees. Now you can see easily alpha is going to be 30 degrees. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and